I was about to interject eh, kasi you're in the long pause. So can we proceed to the next issue that
Yes.
we're supposed to tackle? The issue of those poor Chinese nationals who was caught in Palawan. These Chinese citizens who were suspected of leading the distribution of fraudulently acquired government issued identification cards and documents, they were apprehended in Palawan by the Bureau of Immigration. So these are the following individuals, Mr. Chair. Wang Tao. Who is Wang Tao? Can you stand up? Li Xiao Ming. Guo Xi Yang. And Liu Xi Yang.
Do you understand English? Do you speak English?
Oh, why do you nod your head if you don't understand? Can we, Mr. Chair, are we allowed to...
Are you the interpreter?
Huh?
Nagtatagalog sila? Tagalog. Nagtatagalog sila? So, okay, sige. Go ahead, Congressman.
Are we going to take their oath?
Of course.
They are foreigners. Of course, under the rules, they are allowed to take their oath. So, Mr. Chairman, I request to take the oath of those Chinese nationals.
1 minute suspension, ha?
Pwede natin silang iupo muna dun sa...
BID.
Okay, Mr. Chairman, may we ask the Bureau of Immigration, since they are the leading agency who apprehended these four Chinese nationals, can you narrate to this committee how it transpired leading to the apprehension of these four nationals? And by the way, we would like to congratulate the Bureau, no, for doing its a good job on these Chinese nationals who are fraudulently doing malicious activities in our country. So go ahead, sir.
Good afternoon, Mr. Chairman and members of this honorable committee. To narrate the conducted operations against the four Chinese nationals, the case was coordinated by counterparts from the AFP and NICA regarding the illegal activities of the four subjects.
Sir, can you kindly speak louder with the mic much nearer to your mouth?
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair, yung apat na subjects po na arrested last March 19 stem from the information relayed by counterparts regarding the illegal activities of the four and possible more foreign nationals in Palawan. Based on the information, they are facilitating the issuance of Philippine IDs, whether it be fraudulently acquired or fake IDs. So the Bureau of Immigration, based on the intelligence information received from the counterparts, recommended to the commissioner, the Bureau of Immigration Commissioner, the issuance of a mission order. So the BI operatives conducted the operation last March 19 and implemented the mission orders against the foreign nationals and was able to arrest four on the same site. So the four was charged for undesirability and undergoing deportation proceedings, Mr. Chair.
You have confiscated different government-issued IDs such as driver's license, postal IDs, birth certificates, passports. How many passports were confiscated by the Bureau of Immigration?
Mr. Chair, dalawang passport lang po. One is PROC passport. Two PROC passports issued to Wang Tao and Li Xiaoming. The two others, Guo Ziyang and Liu Ziyang, until this date, wala pong passports. So no Philippine passports were found on those four subjects. But they, Mr. Chair, sorry.
Yeah, do you have copies of their travel documents when they entered the Philippines? Paano yan pumasok dito? Based on your intel,
Mr. Chair, both all four with issued visas. Two with special with the retiree's visas. The other one is an RA7919 visa holder, and the other one is a permanent visa also.
Anong 7191? Yan yung investors?
Yeah, yun po yung amnesty nung 1996.
Okay. So these four personalities have valid visas when they entered the Philippines?
Yes, Mr. Chair. Okay. But they were arrested for violation of misrepresentation and holding fraudulent Philippine IDs, such as the driver's license and postal IDs. And some shared materials like the titles of the land or property. Okay.
Sino dito sa apat na ito yung merong retirement visa or retirees visa?
Wang Tao and Li Xiaoming, Mr. Chair.
Si who, Wang Bu, stand up. And the other Wang one, Bu. Who else? Retirees visa ito sa kanila?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
You don't seem retired to me. I don't know how you were able to acquire the retirees visa. Sige, please sit down, sit down.
Mr. Chair.
Go ahead, BID.
Yes, Mr. Chair. Though they have a valid visas, like retirees visas and permanent visas, they were arrested for violation of immigration law of being undesirable for holding and in possession of fraudulent Philippine IDs, Mr. Chair.
According to Commissioner Norman, what's the name? Tan Cinco. They were involved in buying of properties and interference in politics? Nag-interview sila sa politika?
Only, Mr. Chair, sa purchasing of the properties. That's, yun lang po.
But they were interfering with the buying of properties involving those politicians where the property is being bought. That's what you're trying to say. Kaya nag-interfere sila sa politika kasi namibili sila ng lupa. Kaya nakikipag-negotiate sila sa mga politiko.
Mr. Chair, sorry, I don't have a knowledge on that particular
but it was,
subject.
It was in the report of the Inquirer. Ayan, no? This foreign national use Philippine documents to avoid inspection, buy property, or even interfere in politics. Tan Cinco was quoted as saying in BI's report. So tanungin natin si ano, Mr. Chairman, the leader of the gang is Mr. Liu. Sino ba si Mr. Liu?
Sino si Mr. Liu?
Ayan. Nagsasalita kayo ng Tagalog? Hindi?
Hindi daw, hindi.
Ay, bakit?
Hindi.
Bakit mo ako naiintindihan? Mr. Liu. Well, siguro, can we... Mr. Chair, are they secure to be seated there while we are asking them questions? Or You are the leader of the group. Ikaw yung pinaka head ng grupo. Boss, you are the boss. You. Who is the boss? Wala, walang boss diyan. So sino yung mga kausap mo yung politiko sa Palawan? Sige po. I'm asking her to sit down but there's no chair available. So isa lang. Delikado ka diyan. Sige, sir. Mr. Liu, being the leader of the group, we invite you to sit over.
You have the privilege to sit down.
Mr. Liu, matagal na po kayo sa Pilipinas. Ilang taon na po?
20.
Ha?
20 years.
20 years na. At marami na po kayong kilala sa Palawan.
Sa Palawan, hindi man kumatagal.
Hindi masyado matagal. So, mga, yung 20 years, saan kayo una nag-stay po?
Sa Cebu, tsaka Lumangkite.
Sa Cebu, sa Casa?
Lumangkite.
Paano po kayo na-involved doon sa klase ng pagkuhan po ng mga government IDs?
Wala man kong idea.
Wala
man ko ID.
Wala ho kayong binibenta mga IDs.
Wala.
Kumbaga, pinabibigay niyo na lang libre na lang ho, ganun.
Wala man ko ID.
So wala ho kayong contact sa government.
Wala man.
So wala kayong kinakausap na mga government agencies doon po sa Palawan.
Wala man. Wala.
Pero may nahuli sa inyo mga dokumento. Pero may nakuha po sa inyo mga dokumento at mga ID governments.
Wala.
Okay, before, if I may, do you have a lawyer with you? May kasama ba kayong abogado?
Wala.
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 So, willing ka bang sumagot sa tanong ng mga miyembro ng committee ito? Because he should be assisted by a counsel. Under our rules, dapat meron po siyang ano. Can we ask any lawyer here to...
But the very issue that we wanted to tackle here is the culpability of the different...
Okay. If I may, yeah, Congressman Dan Fernandez, sure. No, kasi para we won't be accused of, or baka ma-technical tayo, so we'd like to ask them first. Ikaw ba ay willing sumagot sa mga tanong ng mga membro ng komite?
Hindi, kasi hindi man ko tindihan, diba? Hindi man ko tindihan, okay. Lalo kinangnan.
So, meron ba tayong interpreter, marunong? Mandarin? O, ano,
Mr. Chair?
Mandarin.
Ano ha? Mandarin.
Mr. Chair, if they don't have a lawyer, can we assign a lawyer from the house to assist them? But basically, the reason why we invited them is for the members to ask them. If we're not going to ask them and they will not be allowed to answer, maybe we should have not invited them over. And I think yung mga tanong lang po natin, Mr. Chairman, are basically in relation to the culpability of the government agency who connived with these people. Ako, ang focus ko po, Mr. Chairman, sino ba yung mga government agencies that issued documents dito sa mga taong to? But yung kaso po nila, wala po akong pakialam. Pero yung mga government agencies na nakipag-connive dito, yun po ang ipo-focus ko, Mr. Chair. And their answer might help us in trying to find out the truth that indeed, sa investigation natin, there are certain government agencies who are earning money. Sigurado pera to. Driver's license, may kita sila. Sa PSA birth certificate, may kita sila. Sa lahat ng mga ini-issue ng mga to, sigurado tayo na kumikita yung ating government agency.
Bago ipagpatuloy ni Congressman Dan Fernandez, Mandarin, no? Mandarin? You understand Mandarin? Of course, you speak Mandarin. Tama? Si Attorney Suwa, marunong ka ba mag-Mandarin?
No, Your Honor.
Ah, okay. Sino bang marunong mag... Kasi we cannot continue asking him questions because baka ma-technical tayo and we don't want that to happen. So, unless may interpreter at willing naman silang sumagot. Kaya nga, ang tanong natin kanina, ikaw ba ay willing sumagot sa mga tanong? Kasi kung kailangan mo ng abogado, pwede mag-provide ang committee ng abogado para sa iyo. Gusto mo ng abogado?
Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair, nakakaintindi po siya ng Tagalog. If I may, Mr. Chair, baka hindi po niya naintindihan yung term na willing ka ba?
Paano ba
Tagalog? Mr. Chair, hindi naman po masyadong critical yung mga tanong natin. I think we are doing this in different committees when we invite those who are under our government custody. Eh, natatanong po natin sila a little bit of or some factual evidences that we wanted to ferret out. So I think, Mr. Chairman, if you will allow us, you know, but if not, andito naman po si Attorney Romy Acop. He can probably ask him to represent this.
Chairman.
Mr. Chair,
okay.
May I ask the BID?
BID.
Are there criminal cases already filed against the four?
Mr. Chair, wala pa ho. Only administrative charge by the Bureau of Immigration.
In your administrative process, are they not entitled to the right against self-incrimination?
They're entitled to that right, Mr. Chair.
When you investigated them, did they request for a lawyer?
In the absence of their personal lawyer, Mr. Chair, a POW lawyer is...
Yes. Was there a POW lawyer when you investigated them?
During the inquest, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Okay. So, Congressman Fernandez. I asked earlier kung may abogado sila. Wala eh.
Mr. Chair. Pero sa immigration po, yung nakuha po ba natin passport nila, Chinese passport, were you able to get a Filipino passport for this for detainees?
No Filipino passports, Mr. Chair. Only two Chinese passports presented during the inquest. Actually, so, Mr. Chair, they have a private lawyer, no POW lawyer. They have their own
private lawyer.
Oh. So they have a private lawyer.
Sino po yung private lawyer nyo, Mr. Liu? Sino po yung abogado po ninyo? Meron po kayo abogado na Pilipino, di po ba? Ano pong pangalan ng abogado po ninyo?
Abogado mo?
Wala pa man.
Huwag ka na magsinungaling dito. Ay, sinasabi nila, meron ka abogado eh.
Wala man. Wala pa man.
Wala ka abogado?
Wala pa.
Sino nagre-represent sa inyo nung pumunta kayo sa husgado?
Hindi ko alam.
Meron po ba nag-represent sa kanila?
During the inquest proceedings, Mr. Chair.
Meron sila. Alam mo, Mr. Chairman, nagsisinungaling na to. Unang-una pa lamang eh. Kikita na natin.
Pero hindi ako eh. Hindi ko alam eh. Talaga.
Alam mo, sinabi ni ng aming opisyal sa immigration that you have meron kang lawyer na kasama nung pumunta kayo sa husgado. At nakita nila na may kasama kayo. Ngayon sinasabi mo, wala kayong kasama abogado? Wala kang kilala abogado? Hindi mo kilala abogado nyo?
Yung bang nag-inquest kayo, may kasama kang abogado doon?
What? Nandun pa sila sa inquest?
Mayroon natanong, pero hindi pa man na sure na abogado sa amin.
Hindi ka sure kung abogado yun? But he was a private lawyer, correct?
Yes, Mr. Chair. Private lawyer. Pero yung the inquest proceedings was conducted sa BI building po.
Andun po ba sila? Andun sila?
Andun po sila during the
inquest. So kung nandun kayo, kasama mo yung abogado nyo. Nakita mo yung abogado nung kayo in-inquest, correct, Mr. Liu? Nung nag-inquest kayo, nung preliminary, nagkita-kita kayo doon sa piskal. So kasama nyo yung apat, tapos meron kayong kasamang isang tao doon na pinagtatanggol kayo, tama?
Hindi ko tinitin.
Mr. Chair?
Yes, Congressman Ako.
The BI said that they had a private lawyer. May I know who commissioned the private lawyer?
Uh, Mr. Chair, based dun sa Intel operatives, prior to the inquest proceedings, may dumating daw pong lawyer to represent them. March 21, 2024.
May we be privileged to know the name of the lawyer?
We will submit, Mr. Chair. Sa legal division po kasi namin nakukuha yung document.
Mr. Chair, I think before we subject the four to questioning, we have to ask them, you have asked already the first question, whether there's a lawyer to represent them. I think the next question would be, we should ask them whether they want to have to avail of the services of a lawyer. Yun po yung protocol. So, we might as well ask them, but I do not know if...
But I think they're refusing to answer if they wanted to avail. At kanina nga, sige, tanong natin kung they wanted to avail.
Order.
Do they want to have a lawyer?
Excuse me, Congressman Paduano. Congressman Acop has the floor. Please give that privilege to him to finish first before we respond or before we reply. And before that, I'd like to acknowledge the presence of our Deputy Speaker, JJ Suarez. Welcome to this committee on Dangerous Drugs Committee hearing. And of course, the better half, Congresswoman Ann Suarez. Welcome to the Committee on Dangerous Drugs. Okay, please continue, Congressman Acop. Let's give him the privilege to finish what he has to say.
Mr. Chair, Our proceedings in this hall, in this hall of Congress, is governed by rules. I do not know if other members of this committee do not know the rules, but I know the rules. When a witness is supposed to be here and to be asked questions, the rule states we ask him whether he wants to avail of the services of a lawyer. If he says no, if he has no lawyer with him, then we ask him, would he want to avail of the service of a lawyer? And then it is incumbent on our institution to provide him a lawyer. I think that's the rule.
And I agree with that, Mr. Chairman.
Then you do not violate that
yes.
rule.
And that's the reason why, Mr. Chairman, a while ago, when we asked him...
You do not have the floor yet, Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Chairman, may I be recognized?
Because I haven't finished my statement yet.
Let's allow Congressman Acop to finish first before I recognize Congressman Dan Fernandez. Please continue, Congressman Acop.
Now, we are going to ask these people questions regarding their involvement in certain violations of our law. And therefore, our laws guarantee that they are supposed to be protected or their rights are supposed to be protected by a lawyer. Our law says so, or our laws say so. So we have to respect the rights also. And even if we read the rules, the rights of witnesses against self-incrimination should be respected. So, dapat ganun lang. I do not know if we would be legally able to ask questions from these people in the absence of a lawyer of their own choice or a lawyer this institution will provide them. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Congressman Acop.
Mr. Chair,
now you have the floor, Congressman
Dan Fernandez.
Representation
understands fully the rights of these people that we have invited. Actually, they really have this opportunity to bring their own lawyers. And as a matter of fact, a while ago, we asked the immigration officer and they told us that they have a private lawyer. And I believe that when we were asking the leader of these four detainees, we asked him, sabi natin kanina, are you willing to answer all the queries of the members? And hindi naman po siya sumasagot. Tapos we asked again if we wanted to avail the services of the lawyer. Still, hindi rin siya sumasagot. And that's a reason why I stop asking, no, because I know the rights of these people, and I think it's incumbent upon the chairman to decide whether we will be asking him or not anymore. Because what I'm trying to point out, what's the reason we invited them over if we will not be asking questions, di ba? Sana hindi na lang po natin sila inimbita, and that's the reason why we asked them kanina kung willing sila magsalita. Now, if the detainee or these people that we have invited that will said that ayaw nila, and then we will follow. But unfortunately, they are not answering back. Hindi nga sila nagsasabi, kung may lawyer, hindi nila alam. Oh, gusto mo ba sumagot? Hindi ko alam. Those are the answers that we are getting. And kitang-kita naman natin, they are just fooling us. So I think, Mr. Chairman, it is up to the chairman to decide on this matter.
Thank you, Congressman Dan Fernandez, for that lengthy explanation. The reason why the chair was intervened earlier is because I wanted to ask whether the resource persons that we invited is willing to answer questions in the absence of their lawyer or a lawyer. Because if they would require us to provide them with a lawyer, as pursuant to our rules, we must and should provide them a lawyer. And before it got confusing, I gave the privilege and the opportunity to Congressman Acop and Congressman Fernandez to explain and state their position on the issue. Ngayon, since you ask if the chair would decide on this matter, let me go straight directly to the resource person. If he is willing to answer a question without a lawyer. If you need a lawyer, please say so, because we will provide you with a lawyer. Mr. Wangbu, kasabot kag bisaya? Dugay man kasibu.
Kunti.
Oh, konti. Gamay lang, ha?
20 years.
Oh, sige. So, willing kang sumagot sa tanong ng mga membro ng committee ito? Na walang abogado?
Hindi ko masyado matindihan.
So, gusto mo ba ng abogado para mabigyan ka ng guidance?
Oh.
Okay. Ano sabi niya?
Oo daw, sir.
So, gusto mo abogado, bigyan ka namin abogado.
Gusto ba ka abogado?
Oo, o hindi lang. Kung hindi, wala tayong ano. Gusto mo ng abogado, ayaw mo?
Gusto mo hanap ng abogado.
Gusto daw niya, sir, hanap siya ng abogado.
Eh, wala kang sinuhana. Kasi kung wala kang abogado ngayon, ang Kongreso ay magpo-provide ng abogado para sa iyo.
Sabi ni sir, kami dito bigay sa iyo abogado.
Si Chairman, si Chairman,
hello. Hello. May interpreter tayo.
Mr. Chair,
kasi marami tanong yung mga members. Kung ayaw mo sagot, okay lang sa amin. Kasi karapatan mo yon. Pero kung gusto mo sagot na walang abogado, karapatan mo rin. Pero kung gusto mo abogado, karapatan mo din. Bigay kami abogado sa iyo. Ayaw mo sagot?
Sa Chairman, alam naman natin, nagtatanga-tangahan na lang yan. Nakakaintindi naman ng Tagalog yan. 20 taon na nga nakatira dito sa Pilipinas yan. Alam naman hindi nakakaintindi yan. And negotiating with the different government agencies and earning a lot of money with those people working in our own government. Sigurado marunong mag-Tagalog yan. Pinapaikot lang tayo yan.
Okay. So, in this case, sige, balikan na dito, ano? Mr. Wambu. Mabilis eh. Naintindihan niya. So anyway, are there any other information relative to the four Chinese nationals from the BID?
Chairman? Chairman?
Let's allow first the BID to reply and then Congressman.
Yeah, BID nga eh.
Is
the BID.
May tanong yan. Oh, please answer my question first before another question is asked by a member.
No other additional or further information, Mr. Chairman.
Okay. So, thank you. Now, Congressman Paduano, your turn to ask questions.
Thank you, Chairman. So, they were issued different kind of visas, di ba? May dalawang retirement, retirees visa.
Two of the four subjects, Mr. Chair, retirees visa.
Oh, yung sa retirees visa, when was that given to them?
Wala eh. Mr. Chair, with me, copies of the SRRV or the retirees visas, but I can only state the validity, Mr. Chair.
The validity? How about when the time that was issued to them?
It's not with me, Mr. Chair. It's filed sa PRA po, Philippine Retirement Authority, not immigration.
Yung visa?
Uh-huh.
Yung issuance ng visa, wala sa inyo? Yung yes. Date and time?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Dito sa PRA.
Implementing agency lang po kami ng...
Oh, di, Mr. Chairman, in the next hearing, we will invite PRA and produce the document with regards to the issuance of such... Yeah, that's why. This is a motion. Chairman?
Yeah. There's a motion, duly seconded, hearing no objection. The motion of Congressman Paduano is approved.
Second, take note. Chairman, second. A while ago, when... Yung makulit na chairman ng Public Order and Safety asked about how long the staying here in the Philippines. He told this committee that it's 20 years. Now, can you produce the travel records of all these four?
We will submit to this committee, Mr. Chair.
Kasi chairman, gusto ko lang makita kung how frequent they're traveling from the Philippines to China or other places in this country. So, can you submit that to this committee? Mayroon ba? Mayroon kayo?
I'm sorry, Mr. Chair. Can you please repeat that?
Yung travel records po.
Mr. Chair, yesterday we submitted the pertinent materials and documents to the office of the chairman of this committee, Mr. Chair.
No, he was referring to the travel records of the four.
Yeah.
Chinese nationals apprehended by BIA.
Yeah, I just want to see how frequent they're traveling.
Yes, Mr.
The Philippines and
already submitted, Mr. Chairman.
You have submitted. Now, what was the last? I may record kay siguro, when was the last yung entry?
Mr. Chair, latest travel of Mr. Wang Tao alias King Delgado Ong. Last arrival was 27 February 2024 and was admitted under the SRRV or retirees visa. Li Xiaoming.
Sorry, Tony. Ano yun? Entry yun, no? Entry.
27 February 2024.
Entry in the Philippines.
The last travel of
from,
entry po.
From where?
We need to check, Mr. Chairman.
Anyway, you mentioned that you have submitted the travel records of those four and COMSEC is confirming that they never received. They have not received the travel records.
Mr. Chair, I have a copy of the receiving copy received at 5 p.m. yesterday.
So you have a receiving copy? The attachment of the receiving copy, may nandun ba yung ano, mga sinabit nyo? In your possession now?
Yes, Mr. Chair. Attachments, yung commitment order po, yung watchlist order, and travel history of the four subjects, Mr. Chair.
Pati travel history. In short, nandun din po yung last entry.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Okay, thank you. Anyway, Mr. Chair, tingnan ko muna yung mga dokumento, then follow-up na lang mamaya. Thank you.
Mr. Chair? Yes, sir.
Congressman Akop? Yeah.
Yeah. May I ask yung DFA, the PRA has authority to issue visa?
For the retirees visa, Your Honor.
Yes,
Your Honor.
Not DFA?
Not DFA, Your Honor.
Hindi rin BID? yung conversion from tourist to student, working visa.
Not SRRV, Mr. Chen.
So PRA rin.
Yes, Mr. Chen.
Yes. So I agree with the Honorable Paduano kasi may mga instances na rin na naabuso yung pag-issue ng visa ng retirees, yung PRA. Kasi gusto rin namin malaman kung ano yung mga requirements para ma-issue ng visa yung mga foreigners. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Congressman Akop.